Munjal sir, Bapat sir, all the dignitaries, CEOs, organizing committees, Srivastav, Satya Prakash ji, long association, 10 years or more now. Thank you so much for the wonderful opportunity. Really privileged and honored. I heard Munjal sir talking about the times that we are going through. Certainly challenging times, yes. And I have tried to, in the next half an hour, see as to how we can, all of us sitting over here, you know, to our member companies, resolve these challenges. So, the next half an hour is my thoughts on how do we help winning. That is why the topic, can I have my screen here? Jules, I think it went through a couple of transformations in the last about 10 days that I've been talking to Mr. Srivastava as to how that next half an hour that I have here can help us in winning in this disruptive age. That's really, really a big challenge that each and every company is going through today. And as I want to start with this, the challenges first, the strategies that we have to overcome the challenges, and the solutions that we can provide to our member companies in winning in this age. So three parts, 10 minutes, 10 minutes, and 10 minutes. I want to start with Nissan. Because the moment I read this name Nissan, just flip the first two words, it becomes IN and Insan. You know, it is quite surprising to me that you know, Nissan and Insan are, and you talked about the Japanese and the Indian collaboration which is going on here. I think Nissan's presence here in the markets in India. So there are a lot of companies who are coming over here, there are a lot of companies from Japan who have been in the past. The Nissan's, you know, unveiling of IMQ, which they want to call Intelligent Mobility, in Geneva 2019, has given us a new technology, which is about converting the invisible to visible. So whatever the driver cannot see now, from all the corners, will be put on his dashboard to avoid any kind of accidents. So that's the intelligent mobility which is coming to us. Nissan and Insan equation. But the challenges of sustainable growth and disruption, we just read yesterday that the GDP has really come down to 4.5%. It's going to further go down. How do we help our member organizations in achieving excellence by obtaining effective involvement of the employees, generating creative ideas? There is no other way but innovation. We have a fantastic case study from the CEO of Nokia, who says we did not do anything wrong, but still they were completely phased out. Today, the CEOs do not know what went wrong with them. That is, I think, one of the biggest challenges that all of us face. And General Motors filed a bankruptcy. Can you imagine that the number one car company actually filed a bankruptcy a couple of years back? And on the contrary, we have a company called Toyota, which became world's number one. We don't see what's coming ahead of us. I think that's one of the biggest challenges that we have got. Apple never, you know, the music companies, they never accepted the challenge of the MP3. And you know what has happened to the music industry? It's completely got disrupted. Motorola, they talked about Six Sigma, more than six new products, and it phased out. Disruption is happening everywhere. And Clayton Christensen of Harvard Business School says that the physical structures of the banks have absolutely been evaporated. Your bank is a hotspot on a phone. You can imagine what's happening with the driverless. Things are definitely in a very, very tight situation. LinkedIn today has become a job recruiter. The transformation is happening, and you can imagine what happens to Naukri.com and people who started their new ventures. Disruption is happening every time. Udemy is giving challenges to the universities. Online education is disrupting the physical structures of the universities today. People are not there. Alexa has become a voice assistant or a concierge in a hotel or a healthcare industry. What kind of age are we going through? So what happened to JET? The inability of changing. They started with corporates and they ended with corporates. Indigo, on the other hand, saw the markets coming out from the other players and they seized it. So what happened to Thomas Cook? They're all being disrupted. But there is a ray of hope. There is the new rules. This is all happening because we are trying to fit in the round peg in a square hole. The world has changed. In the next 10 minutes, I want to talk about those new rules. It's a reset world. It calls for a different kind of thinking. And the most important thing that the organizations that requires to be done today is to become nimble, agile, fertile, but open innovation culture. You know, as long as your rate of internal change is faster than the external rate of change, you keep winning. And the moment it becomes slower, you disrupt. You are completely disrupted. So I think creating a new future of an organization is one of the biggest things. How do we all create a new future for the company? If you go through Vijay Govindarajan's book, The Three Boxes, he talks about the past box and the present box, but the most important box, which is the future box, nobody concentrates on. And that is where the problem is. Most of these companies who got disrupted, they were never able to create or anticipate a new future. Toyota saw the new future in a Prius about 15 years back. General Motors continued to make Hummers and Buicks and Saabs. Customers could never see that company as an innovative organization. The perception was so bad. So the future box is one of the most important boxes that we need to create. And a classic example is when Al Casimano took over IBM. So IBM is a hardware company or a software company? Many people struggle to find out the answer today. IBM became a software company from a hardware company. Because he knew that the world is going to look for smart solutions. Al Casimano even sold off his computers to Lenovo. Imagine a company which created the computers does not deal in computers anymore. They said that our strategic efficiency is greater than the operating efficiency. He said, if my men can create computers, they can create wonderful solutions. Let them focus on creating wonderful solutions. From 20% software, IBM became a 20% hardware company today, and even less than that. The same happened to Jeff Bezos of Amazon. Can you imagine that a bookseller today sits pretty with Google and Microsoft as the world's largest cloud player? Because he could see a future. That is where we are not, that is why our Indian companies are not able to come out. And it is a disruption of the traditional innovation. Let me tell you, even the way we used to innovate has got disrupted. So we have a CEO of Procter & Gamble who came out with Eddie Lafley, who came out with an idea of connect and develop, the C&D. And today, he tells all his CEOs, I have $60 billion as my turnover. In the next year, I want to have $90 billion dollars as my turnover, but without innovations, internal innovations. So people ask him, how? How is that possible?